teenage daughter who attended Harper Valley Junior High. Well, her daughter came home one afternoon and didn't even stop to play. And she said, Mama, got a note here from the Harper Valley PTA. Well, the note said, Mrs. Johnson, you're wearing your dresses way too high. It's reported you've been drinking and are running around with men and going wild. And we don't believe you ought to be bringing up your little girl this way. And it was signed by the secretary, Harper Valley PTA. Well, it happened that the PTA was gonna meet that very afternoon. And they were sure surprised when Mrs. Johnson wore her mini skirt into the room. And as she walked up to the blackboard, I can still recall the words she had to say. She said, I'd like to address this meeting of the Harper Valley PTA. Well, there's Bobby Taylor sitting there, and seven times he's asked me for a date. And Mrs. Taylor sure seems to use a lot of ice whenever he's away. And Mr. Baker, can you tell us why your secretary had to leave this town? And shouldn't Gwitta Jones be told to keep her window shades off or completely down? Well, Mr. Harper couldn't be here 'cause he stayed too long at Kelly's bar again. If you'll smell Shirley Thompson's breath, you'll find she's had a little nip of gin. And then you have the nerve to tell me you think that as a mother I'm not fit. Well, this is just a little Peyton place and you're all Harper Valley hypocrites. No, I wouldn't put you on because it really did, it happened just this way. The day my mama socked it to the Harper Valley PTA. The day my mama socked it to the Harper Valley PTA.
You know Herbie and Verge. They get a loud line once in a while, but they're harmless. Okay. Okay, I'll join the church, and I'll only have the ladies over to sip tea. Honey, I am what I am. A few beers, a couple of songs, everyone can close the windows. Anyhow, I bet they're copying down the words.
This is for you.
So, who are the lords of Harper Valley buzzing about now?
Why don't you read it?
Gossip is the cheapest form of conversation. They've probably got some dirt on someone and they want to pass it along officially.
It's about you.
Me?
You're not exactly the pillar of the community, you know.
Well, I am still your mother, young lady, and don't you forget it.
Sometimes I wish I could.
Let's have it. The last time you looked like that was when Dee wasn't invited to the Otis Harper Day picnic.
Damn, damn, damn!
As bad as that, huh? Dear Miss Johnson, while it's not the business of this council to tell anyone how to live, too many incidents have come to our... Still, I don't believe this. The young men of our community should not be tempted by seeing skirts that are far too revealing. If drastic changes are not made, steps will be taken to see that Dee is expelled. Signed, Olive Glover, Secretary, Harper Valley, PTA. Decent attitude! Them biddies wouldn't know a decent attitude if it got into bed with them. Still? Oh, still, honey. Now, Still, you're not gonna let this junk get to you, are you? Oh, honey, come on. Still, come on. Now, they got so much dirty linen, it's just filling up their great big walk-in closets. Well, I ought to know. That grand old bitch of the PTA, Miss Flora Simpson Riley, is just a walking, talking tape recording of every juicy bit of scandal in this whole lousy town. I mean, every time she comes into the La Moderne shop, she just yaks to all of my hairdressers. I mean, well, you know me, honey. I'm just in one ear and out the other, Alice. But boy, she just goes on and on and on.
Alice?
What?
Come here.
Now, Stell.
You sit down.
Sam. Stell, I ain't gonna do it.
Now you start talking. And don't you leave out a single dirty detail.
Mama, I really don't want to go in.
Oh, no, honey. You're coming with me. This is something I want you to hear.
I personally think jump ropes would be a lot cheaper than a trampoline.
Well, I've never bought either, so I would have no idea.
I hope you're all right, dear.
Oh, I didn't want black bread. You eat them.
Yes, dear.
Skeeter?
Oh, thank you.
Black bread.
Please, people, will you kindly take your seats? We have a full agenda this afternoon.
Oh,
This meeting will come to order. The first order of business is...
I'd like to address this meeting of the Hopper Valley PTA.
Point of order. There are no motions from the floor called for at this time. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Unanimous. The chair denies.
Let her speak.
Sure, Stell. What you got in your mind?
I'd like to hear, too.
This is still an open forum for Harper Valley citizens, and everyone has the right to be heard.
Willis Newton, may I remind you that you have no children in this school system?
Quite true, ma'am. But then I am on the board of the PTA, and I am building the new gymnasium for the school.
You wrote me a letter that I'd like to reply to in public. You say I'm not fit to live in this fine American town. That I don't come up to your standards, or whatever you consider decent. Well, I am here to call a few kettles black. How you doing, Bobby Taylor? If I haven't turned you down 7 times for lewd proposals, I haven't turned you down once. If I were you, Holly, I'd have taken this man in and had him neutered. Oh, and Holly, honey, you better lay off the booze. Or Max Liquor Store is going to come and take your home for the booze bill.
And Mr. Kirby Baker, a fine real estate executive. Baker Realty. Honesty. Honesty since 1938.
Your secretary, poor little Gladys Wilmot. She had to leave town awful sudden.
Cool it.
Had to see a special kind of doctor in Cincinnati.
If you all know what I mean.
And oh, I know the nights are just so warm that poor Willa Mae just has to leave her shades open an inch or so. Just to catch the cool summer breezes.
Of course.
And don't a few of our more prominent citizens simply love to stroll by Willa Mae's house these summer evenings and peek through the shades just for the entertainment? Oh, did you stay too long at Kelly's bar again, Otis? Oh, yes.
We mustn't forget our illustrious town founder's offspring, Otis Hopper Jr. That fine cornerstone of the community, drinking up all the leftovers at Kelly's bar every night at closing time. Ooh, and I'll bet if you checked Shirley Thompson's breath, you'd find she just took a little nip of gin. But, lest we forget, Miss Olive Glover, the grand secretary of this council. Poor Olive. She keeps such good books. But she's got this teensy-weensy little gambling problem that everyone knows about, but no one would ever speak of in public, of course. I mean, no one would ever speak of any of these terrible lies in public. Would they, Mrs. Flora Simpson Riley? And I'm saving up something special for you. Oh, let's face it, this here is just a little patent place and you're all a bunch of Hopper Valley hypocrites.
Come on, honey, let's go.
Hey, look, honey, I'm sorry if I embarrassed you.
No big deal, Mom. Diary. Sorry I haven't written lately, but so much has been happening. Mainly, Mama busted up the Harper Valley PTA meeting and really socked it to them. She called them a bunch of hypocrites and spilled the beans about them all. I'm sure it'll leave us at the bottom of the town's popularity poll, but that'll teach him not to screw around with my mama. A man there named Will Newton had big eyes for her, so I suppose we'll be hearing from him any minute now. It's late, and I'm tired. Good night.
Word got around you had a little trouble here.
Nothing we can't take care of ourselves, Mr. Newton.
Mr. Newton? Sounds like my grandfather.
Don't send me letters and then come around and try to clean up a mess you helped to create.
Sure is hot.
Yeah. It's gonna get hotter. What kind of game are you playing, Mr. Newton?
Well, if you call me Mr. Newton one more time, I'm gonna have to go out and buy myself a cane. It's Will. And I've been out of town for over a month. And the guy who forged my name on that letter is in big trouble. Ma'am? Little ma'am?
Dee? Hmm? You're not eating anything.
I'm not really hungry right now.
Dee, baby, I'm sorry about the PTA thing. I just lost my...
Oh, that's okay, really. I understand. It's just such a bummer that the kids could be so mean.
Well, maybe they've got it out of their system now.
Wardrobe and those bags under your eyes.
Oh, thanks. I needed that.
Jean! Miss Plummer, I'm going to have Jean finish you up. Come on, I'm going to fix you an Alice special. Drink.
Tastes like raw eggs and Kool-Aid.
It is, with a shot of brandy.
Ooh.
Hey, Stell, honey, I heard about it through the grapevine.
That's not the half of it. A rock came through my window last night with a message on it. Alice, it's getting out of hand. Now, a prank's one thing, but they're getting mean.
Oh, Stell, those awful kids.
Oh, there's more than kids behind that. Now, kids think of the toilet paper thing, you know? But it takes an adult mind to think of something that nasty.
Stell, what are you gonna do? Move?
No. No, I'm not gonna move. You sure he's gonna show up?
Oh, Stell, honey, will you stop worrying? Look, I told Rosalie Wilson you and me was coming here, and then I seen her tell Cranky Barney the mailman, and you know how those things go. If Bobby Taylor don't know you're here by now, he'll never know.
Mm-hmm. Hey, Bobby! Hey, Bob! Did you hear the one about the cat that ate the cheese and sat in front of a mouse hole with bated breath?
No.
Well, look who's here. Beauty and the Beast.
Why don't you go find a nice quiet cave someplace and settle in for the winter?
Hey, Still. Long time no see, huh?
Oh, hey, now that's original.
Yeah. I really tried to defend you at the meeting. I mean, I asked them to let you talk, didn't I? You came down pretty hard on us. My wife still has me sleeping in the rumpus room.
Well, that's all right, Bobby. You got your guns to keep you company.
You like guns, Stell? Gee, I didn't know that. I got a pistol I took off a dead gook. Shot him right in the ear with it.
Well, tell me all about it, Bobby. Death just fascinates me.
It does. Gee, Stell.
Would you excuse me? I have to go powder something.
Before I get sick.
Herbie, another for the lady, and ginger ale on the rocks for me. Hey, Still. So I loaded her up with old number 12 shot and let her fly. Got that turkey right in the gut. Ate him anyway, buckshot and all. Still. Boy, you're some kind of woman.
You think so, Bobby?
Mm-hmm.
Hurry up. I can't wait.
Bobby.
All the way. All the way. Oh, Bobby, darling, would you be a dear and go put the do not disturb sign out?
Thank you.
Hey, buddy, where's the fire?
Dee, honey, it's after 8 o'clock. Get up, lazy bones. You're going to be late for school.
I don't feel good.
Oh.
Kids are giving you a hard time, huh?
It's not that. I just don't feel good. My stomach hurts. It's a female thing, if you know what I mean.
Well, I'll leave a note on the table for you in case you want to go in late.
Okay.
Meanwhile, I shall be over on the north side trying to sell those frumps Angel Glow Cosmetics to make them beautiful.
Mama? Were you pretty when you were 14?
Baby, I was plain as dirt. But when I was 17, I won a beauty contest. Miss Libertyville. That's when I met your daddy. Well, I gotta go now. We'll talk about it later. Hmm? You feel better, honey, huh?
Well, hi, Corley. Hey, you sure you got the right house?
Sure do, Mrs. Johnson. It says right here, Mrs. Johnson.
Well, you wait right there. I'll get you something.
It's all right, ma'am.
I'm just glad to come by. You're sort of a hero to a lot of folks around here.
That's so?
Yes, ma'am.
Well.
Wow. Thanks.
May I see you again? Thought your performance at the PTA was nothing less than sensational. Yours truly, Willis Newton.
Better check it for a bomb.
Will Newton, I am really flattered. That man is a true gentleman. Oh. Oh, the last time anyone sent me roses was... Where was your daddy?
Well, now, don't you look like the cat that swallowed the canary.
You got something going I don't know about?
Uh-huh. All right, who is it?
Only the most eligible man in the county.
Moose Harper?
Will Newton.
No, you mean he's interested?
Well, I guess you might say he's interested to the tune of a dozen of these. Lamadern, a beauty shop. Oh, good day, Miss Riley.
The old battle axe herself.
Yes, Miss Riley, we have your appointment. 11 o'clock. Permanent Nisette. Right. And Leona's going to do you, that's right. Right. Good day, Miss Riley.
Oh, boy, she's been calling every hour on the hour. Is she ever uptight? She's having one of her big bashes today, you know.
Alice, you're going to give Leona the day off, and you're going to do Miss Flora yourself.
Stella, you're up to something. And I ain't going to do it.
No, I'm not.
No, I'm not. No, I'm not. Yes, I am.
You sure it'll work?
Guaranteed.
To give anything to see Flora's face at that party?
Laura, your granddaughters play divinely.
Well, good breeding shows. Thank you. Oh, now, allow me. There. Fresh bowl of punch.
Oh, yes, ma'am. Right away, ma'am. Excuse me, please.
Olive, how are the sales going?
Oh, we're going very well.
Oh, that... isn't that wonderful? Yes.
Well... Laura, what a terrific party.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, I'd like you to meet Gary Gavini.
Oh. Oh, how Italian. Are you having a good time, Shirley?
Oh, just more.
Oh, have our picture taken. Yes. Did you hear the children's concert?
Oh, I think so.
Oh, I'm so glad. My dear friends, I can't tell you how delighted I am at having you all here as guests in my home. I do want to thank all of you for your generosity this afternoon. Thank you. Oh, Holly, what happened to my hair? My beautiful hair! God, I'm ruined. I'm absolutely ruined. Don't you dare!
Now, we still don't have the first two bars. Oh, there's Carlisle. You better just forget him. He's hot for one of the twins.
I couldn't be less interested.
If he had two heads, you'd be interested. Oh, here he comes.
Shut up. Hi.
Well, hi yourself.
How you been?
Okay.
You were off key.
Well, my mouth hurts.
From kissing Bettina Riley, no doubt.
How do you know that?
A little bird.
Well, she chews a lot of certs. I think I got a canker sore.
You better watch who you converse with, Carlisle. I hear it's catchy.
Well, I've got to be going. I'll see you.
I wouldn't want anything to rub off.
Hey, don't get finty. It's a free country, you know. The Fifth Amendment says your mother can say anything she wants.
First Amendment.
Yeah, that's what I meant. I'll see you.
Three strikes and you're out.
You want to pick me up here or you want me to pick you up? Why don't you stop by here and pick me up? That'll be easier. Got a girl now, Charlie, my wild fantasies just walked into the room. Hi, Stella.
Hi, Herbie.
Hey, Stella, did you hear the one about the two brand new born babies that were next to each other in the nursery? And a little girl baby said to the little boy baby, she said, are you a little boy baby or are you a little girl baby? The little boy baby says, I'm a little boy baby. And the little girl baby says, how do you know you're a little boy baby? And with that, the boy baby whipped off the blankets and said, see that? Blue booties.
Herbie, I'd like to ask you a favor.
You name it, Stella. Who do I have to kill?
Have you still got that home movie outfit? You know, the one you won on the TV quiz show?
Yeah, sure. Matter of fact, it's still in the box. Who have I got to take pictures of?
I'd like to borrow it.
Okay. What, are you taking a trip or something, Sal?
Yeah, Herbie. It's going to be a real good trip.
I'll stop back there with all the other stuff I want. I'll get it for you.
Uh-huh. Hey, watch the store, will you?
Oh, Stella, it's got a whole bunch of gadgets in there, zoom lenses, tripod, and the film is even good, I think.
Oh, thank you, Herbie.
Yeah, keep it as long as you want.
I'll take real good care.
Okay. Hey, Stella, do you hear the one of... never mind.
Good evening, Otis.
Barney the mailman.
What you doing down there, Mr. Crunk?
I dropped some letters this morning. I had to come back and find them. Come here. Come here. Here's $5.
What's this for, Mr. Crunk?
You take it in good faith, boy. Now, I'll deliver these.
Well, thanks a lot, Mr. Crunk.
Get out of here.
Why, Barney Crunk. Oh, I didn't know you delivered flowers, too.
Rain or shine, I deliver. You mind if I come in for a bit, Miss Jones?
In Chicago on some sort of land deal.
Mm-hmm.
Well, he doesn't let me in on all his movements.
Don't worry, honey. He will. Boy, sure keeps him coming, don't he? That's the doorbell.
No kidding.
For you. I had to come back double for this. The old 30 cents postage.
Well, now, I think I have 30 cents right here, Barney.
Had to make two trips.
Were you just mad because you couldn't peek and see what was inside?
Huh.
It's here, it's here.
What is it?
Oh, is that it?
Yes.
Oh, wow. Oh, it only took a week.
Well, for $30, they ought to send it by special messenger.
You know, I never seen a real... plain brown wrapper before.
Well, in the ad, they said they'd process anything, so this must be pretty tame stuff for them.
You know, Stell, I'd have given my eye teeth to have really watched what really went on.
And get caught peeking in someone else's window? Listen, a camera's enough. Come on, we can see it.
Okay.
Get the glass.
Right.
Alice...
Hey, that ain't Corley.
Oh, my God.
What?
Oh, my God, it's Cranky Barney. And he just delivered this package himself.
Yeah.
Oh, thank goodness he couldn't look inside like he usually does.
Come on, let's splice it in.
Okay. Huh? Hey, are you sure you can get this film back
for Sure. You know, the janitor's wife said, Custer, all it's going to cost me is a free set and comb out. It's all arranged.
Yeah.
bet you it's more birds and bees. I knew this stuff when I was seven.
Just nod and say, oh, really, Amon. If you don't, you get a note sent to your mother. I knew.
Class. Class. Now, today, we are going to show a special film dealing with sex education. Class! Class! Now, as future wives and mothers, we must stress the important functions of the human body and the real purpose they serve.
Edwina, Bettina, dears, would you pull down the shade?
Yes, Mrs. Jones.
Good girl.
All right, let's see the film. If any of you think that sex is a laughing matter, wait until you get married.
This film deals only with the basic structure and function of the human reproductive process. An understanding of this process is important for all, and begins with the simple, clear knowledge that birth is the result of a physical union of the father and the mother, who contribute equally to the conception and resulting birth of their child. It is the reproductive system of each that we are now going to consider. Reproductive systems that are developed to an almost unbelievable degree of complexity and perfection.
Oh, he's so small.
My little brother is more than that.
Girls! Now, we're going to have a test on this material later. I suggest you watch this film very closely.
To understand how this can lead to the birth of a baby, let us turn our attention to the woman's reproductive system.
On the surface of a woman's genital organs are folds of skin or tissue called labia. As we can see in this schematic view, the labia protect the opening of the urethra through which urine from the bladder is emptied.
Bring back the boys.
And it also shields the entrance to the vagina. At the upper end of the vagina is the cervix, which is Latin for neck. Neck of the uterus. The uterus is a pear-shaped hollow organ, frequently called the womb.
I think it is Mrs. Jones.
My God!
Boy, Mrs. Johnson, this delivering sure getting profitable. Between you and Mr. Newton and Barney the mailman, I'm gonna retire.
Keep seeing you as long as you're not too busy.
Too busy?
Well, I do have a rather busy social calendar, what with my merry round of cocktail parties and the cotillion ball coming. coming up. I'm so busy, you know.
Oh. How do you survive this town?
I work. Oh, I keep busy. I make a living. Sell cosmetics from door to door. I guess you could say I sell a little bit of happiness in a jar.
But you ought to run for political office. Hey, you know, that's not a bad idea. And you could start with the PTA.
Oh, come on.
No. Get rid of that awful potato head Flora Simpson Riley and her snobby friends. What, between them, they haven't done anything for that school in 10 years. Why, on the new gymnasium, I had to fight them tooth and nail until I agreed to pay for the repairs out of my own pocket. All they ever do is give parties and barbecues and backyard socials to raise money, most of which comes out of the treasury to pay for the parties to raise more money.
You mean to say that my contributions go into that cheap champagne that Mrs. Riley serves at her fancy guzzling parties?
Absolutely. Now, I think the kids could get behind your kind of programs.
Oh, what programs? I don't have programs.
Well, maybe not, but you would never cheat them out of what's theirs and not their parents.
Oh, my goodness. That's too much to think about right now. All in a minute, heavens.
Whoa. Oh, oh, oh. Stella?
Some poker.
Well, I play the harmonica a lot.
Oh, I've got to go in. You know, Dee won't go to sleep until I switch on that light. Maybe just one more. A little one.
Now, have you changed your mind about the school board? Because the election is coming up and old Flora has got it in the bag.
Oh, no, that's too much for me to think about. You... Flora Simpson Riley. I've got to go. Well, I had fun. It's been a long time.
Tells Alice to be here at 10:30. Alice is here at 10:30. But is Stella here at 10:30?
Oh.
Oh, no. See, because Stella's out gallivanting with Mr. Blue Blood while Alice sits around here getting calluses on her astrobadistra.
Alice, don't you move. Now I'm going to be ready in 10 seconds. 10 seconds.
Got a passenger?
Hi, I thought you might need a hand.
You know?
I have my suspicions.
Well, welcome aboard the Harper Valley Steamroller.
Thank you.
Well, you know, honey, you sure can drive this truck.
I can handle anything on four wheels. My daddy taught me to drive his truck when I was 14.
Won't somebody find out about us?
No, they won't find out about us. They even rented this thing over in Brookdale. Hey, come on, you guys. Now, have a little faith, will you?
That's my room.
Okay, I'll go check and see if he's asleep yet, and then you can bring him around.
Right, check.
Oh, this, you're drunk.
I swear to God, I'll never drink again.
Otis, Otis, you're a lunatic. You're crazy.
No, I swear to God, I'll never drink
Otis,
again. I swear, I'll never drink again.
Get off my stomach. Go back to bed and dry up.
No, no.
Keyed up, I guess.
Me too. Do you want some chicken?
Oh, yeah, I'm starved. Oh, every time I think of Otis Harper's face, I could die.
I know. I'm never going to be able to look at anything pink again.
I stopped by Dr. Carey's office on my way home from work yesterday.
Oh, yeah? To pay another bill?
No.
No, to
talk about braces and
cabbages and kings.
What did he say? He said maybe.
Oh, Mama, please let it be.
Saturday morning. Oh, now, don't get too excited, hon. He said maybe. And I didn't spend $1,400 for you to end up with crooked teeth. Maybe we'll stop by Alice's on our way home. My goodness. Where'd my little girl go?
Okay. Bottom. Okay. There you are.
Come on, honey. I want to see him at $1,400.
Oh, baby.
Baby, that's terrific.
Oh, that's terrific.
Alice, how's it going? Is everything all right?
Will you get out of here? I can't work.
Just a little peek. I'll only open one eye.
Stella, now you wouldn't interrupt Pete Castle when he's creating, would you?
Oh, you bet I would. If it was my kid, I'd come on,
go get yourself some coffee. She's in a real trouble. She is. Stella.
Dracula's daughter, baby.
Mama, is that really me?
It always was you, honey. Oh.
It always was you. Guy.
Who I think it is.
That's Dee Johnson. What has she done to herself?
Jeez, did you see that? He almost passed out when he saw you. Carlisle, look.
I don't know if I'm going to like this new me.
Yeah, well, I'll take some of the cast off men if you don't want
them. Hey, you're a foxy. Hey, Dee, is that you?
Yeah, it's me, Lenny. Old railroad tracks.
Lift your feet, Lord.
Hey, Dee. You gonna watch me run?
Why? Do you do it differently than anyone else?
Yeah, on all fours. Hey, what's up, Dee?
Nothing. What should be up?
Well, I just want to say you look terrific. I mean, the change is really incredible.
That's what everyone says. But it's still me, Carlisle. I'm still the same person I was 1 week ago when no one would talk to me.
Well, I'm talking to you. I always did, didn't I?
I guess you did. I'll see you around.
Hi, honey.
Oh, Dee. Want a hot dog?
No, thanks. What's the matter, baby? Oh, boys are just so idiotic. Like children.
Honey, when the caterpillar turns into the butterfly, everyone is amazed.
I'm still me, though. I'm still Dee Johnson.
Oh, baby, baby. When God gives you that kind of equipment, you just relax and appreciate it.
Now how about a hot dog?
Yeah.
Will the contestants please take their positions?
One of the hazards.
Oh, come on, Mama.
How about another hot dog?
Okay. It's been a couple of weeks. What's the word? Are you gonna run?
Oh, well, I can't.
You can.
I know what you're trying to do, Will Newton, and it won't work. I won't do it. Will? Will, I can't.
Sure you can.
Oh, Will? Will, I...
For me, you'll like it, you'll see.
Will Newton, you are the most persistent man I have ever...
We are going to do it together.
The PTA membership election form, please. The presidential ballot.
Oh, yeah, sure. Here you go.
Thank you, Mavis, dear.
Get off of that.
I've called this meeting because this woman must be stopped at all costs.
That's a good idea.
Now, I'm declaring for a petition to be signed by every upstanding citizen of Harper Valley.
That's a good idea.
Imagine that tart thinking she could be PTA president. Why, it's unthinkable.
I could strangle that Will Newton. I mean, who does he think he is anyway? Just because he's so damn good looking.
Good looking? He's gorgeous.
Where's Skeeter Dugan?
He sent word. He won't be able to attend the meeting.
Oh, that's too bad. Sure could have used his notary stamp right now.
What's up, Curb? You got a plan?
Well, up to now, there was no reason to tell you about this. But old Harry Johnson and I had this deal on his house, and Kirby Realty holds this little old second mortgage that's been foreclosable for years now.
Kirby Baker, you mean you had the means to run this woman out of town and you never spoke up?
There was no need to, Flora. Didn't think about it till just now. Had it tucked away in my files years before Harry died.
Well, go and get it, man. Don't just sit there.
Hey, Stella?
Yeah?
How goes the battle?
Why do I get into these things?
Oh, now, honey, you're going to be great. I can just see it. Stella, destined for bigger and better things.
Here, I brought you your mail.
Thank you. You know, talk down at the beauty shop's running 7-4 in your favor. Seems an awful lot of folks are getting real sick of old Flora the Mouth Riley.
Why, that lousy, no-good son of a... $1,800. Now, how am I going to get $1,800? I'm going to lose his house.
Did Harry really do this?
I don't know. I don't know. He bought an awful lot of new equipment when he was talking about going into his business. Oh, Harry. He told me his aunt in Springfield lent him the money.
Boy, and you mean Kirby never said one word about this?
Well, he owns the house, legally. It's gone up in value. Why should he say anything? He'd have lost a bundle.
Well, what you gonna do? You gonna go dig up old Gladys Wilmot?
Well, she's gone off to Toledo or someplace. You know, that's not bad.
Hmm?
That's not bad at all. And I know just the person to get old Kirby down on the waterbed and out for the count. Babe, you do me a favor. You just take these little cards, this pencil, this book. Get to work, honey. Call you later.
You do. Where are you going?
Well, I'm off to get me something Chinese. And I don't mean chop suey.
May I see Mr. Kirby Baker?
Did you have an appointment?
No.
Baker Realty? Oh, yes, Mr. Brooks. It went into escrow today. We'll call you as soon as we hear something. Goodbye, Mr. Brooks.
Is he in?
Let me check.
Excuse me, Lola. I'll take care of this young lady personally. Now, what can I do for you, Miss...
Wong. Myrna Wong. I'm looking for a small house to rent. Just myself. Something, private and out of the way.
Out of the way? Well, let old Kirby show you about. Won't you step into my office?
Thank you.
Will this house be for business or pleasure?
A little of both.
Yes, of course. That gown is lovely. Hong Kong?
No. New York.
Really? New York? Just subdue the light a bit. So darn bright eyes. Music. Come sit by me, and we'll look through the listings together. Oh, here's a French provincial. Two beautiful oak trees. And a little place for your puppy dog, if you have one.
Crazy lady.
Far out, baby. You have humor. Lion, Mama. Yeah. Kinky. Kinky.
Hey! Police, I've been assaulted.
Well, that woman will not get a seat on my board.
No, my love.
Kirby Baker will see to that.
You always knew the cleanest method of finding a solution, my love.
Mm-hmm. Eat your fowl, Henry. Hello, Mrs. Riley here. Kirby Baker did what? In jail. Oh, get everyone over here tonight. Yes, tonight. Oh, it is time to fight fire with fire.
Yes, my love.
That's on me. Hey, Bobby.
Oh, hi. Looking for your fire hose? Huh? Tex?
I'm Dutch. He's Tex.
How do you do?
You got the money?
Half now. Half when the job is done.
I like you one little bitch, you know that fella?
All right, what's the deal? This rich bitch, Flora something Riley, sends out feelers in the cities, and we spend gas money coming to this burg.
Who the hell's this Skeeter fella, and how do we dispose of his body?
No, we don't want him hurt.
You don't want him hurt?
No.
What is this, Tex? We running a babysitting service now or something?
Will you shut up?
Everything's in here. All the instructions. No, we don't want him hurt. We just want to keep him from voting.
That's kidnapping, right?
No, nothing like that. Just hold him at the old monastery until the PTA board finishes voting.
Monastery? You say monastery? Admit it, I'm blowing this burg. That's it.
Hello, Rusty Nail. Widowmaker. Ginger ale.
Rocks.
It's on me, Herbie.
I'll put it on your wife's then.
Well, Dutch?
I'm Tex. He's Dutch. Okay, Mr. Whatever your name is. You got yourself a deal. Let's drink to it.
Skeeter!
Will you stop watching that TV set long enough to take the trash out? This is Wednesday. And take the dog out, too. The poor thing hasn't gone all day. You're the one who wanted a dog, you know.
Yes, dear. Oh, that woman. One of these days.
Let's go.
Got it.
Hi, fellas. Can I help you?
Would you tell me what's going on?
Mm-hmm. I was in there just now.
Uh-huh.
And I look into the office, and there's Sticky Fingers Olive Glover jimmying open the drawer. She's got the milk fund rally money, and she's dumping half it out on the floor.
She was robbing the fund money?
Mm-hmm.
Mavis, I can't believe that.
Believe it? I saw it with my own four eyes.
Mavis, you've got to tell the sheriff.
Oh, sure. And who do you think they're going to bust? Olive Glover? Wrong. Me.
Stark raving mad.
The police said they found Mavis's library card in the door between the two offices.
I told you she was watching Olive Glover steal the money.
We know that, baby. No one here suspects Mavis for a minute. Now, the problem is...
The problem is I'll get my hands on Olive Glover and I'll beat the living hell out of her.
Whoa, down, girl. Now, we'll land us all in jail unless we take this one thing at a time. Now, let's break it down. First thing we have to do, we'll detail jobs. Now, I'll take Herbie with me, and we'll try and track down what the heck happened to Skeeter Duggan.
You know, that is so strange, because Skeeter is so predictable.
Two beers, he goes home to his wife. Three beers, he goes home to his mother-in-law. Four beers, he goes...
Herbie!
Now, you and Alice follow Olive Glover. Now, unless I miss my guess, she'll head straight for the home stretch and lay some of that rally money on the nose.
Which means she'll probably stop by the stables to check out the ponies and get a hot tip.
I donated 5 brand new $20 bills marked consecutively Good Luck Harper Valley High in the margin.
Oh.
Get them, and we've got her. D. Now, the board is supposed to vote on acceptance of candidates. I've already sent my proxy for Stella, and I know 5 others who are on my side.
Brother... A tie? 6-6?
It's a stalemate, as far as I know, and they can make that last for years, maybe even postpone the election. Now, what I need you to do is interrupt that meeting with all kinds of floor questions.
Can you do that, babe?
Yeah.
Good. Now, you give us enough time, and we'll find Skeeter, and I just have a feeling that he'll swing his vote our way.
Oh.
Bingo. It's post time. She took a purse.
Well, let's just relieve her of it.
You crazy. Now, let's just wait her out.
I call this meeting of the council board to carry out the election of the president of the PTA.
I'd like to address the board.
Young lady, you are out of order.
According to the bylaws of the Harper Valley School District system, it says here, any person legally embraced by the Harper Valley District may petition at any time any officer, member of the school system, or its governing bodies for redress of grievance. And since I am legally embraced as a student of this school system, I reserve that right.
Would you ask your question and be quick about it, Miss Johnson?
I refer to the minutes of September 8, 1968, wherein this board was first elected.
1968? Well, we cannot hold the vote of this board on a question of a meeting that many years ago.
It says here, and I quote, minutes of all activities must be kept on file if they pertain to the business of the school system as a whole. You do have the minutes kept, do you not?
Yes, of course we do. Where is Olive Glover? Well, it seems that Miss Glover is off on a personal errand. Well, let's get on with it.
I'm sorry, but parliamentary rules state...
This meeting is adjourned until somebody can find Olive Glover.
Get some fresh air.
Oh, yeah.
It ain't exactly Chanel number 5 around here, you know. What? What? What?
Shh, shh, it's coming.
Oh.
Mavis stole that money. Oh. Nobody's gonna believe you. How you?
Out of that one smelling like a rose.
Well, I hear it's good for the complexion.
Oh, yeah.
Trail Road, cannot set down. Suggest you investigate maroon van.
you.
You're coming in two by two, Barbelly. We'll investigate maroon van. Over and out, honey. This is deep set.
Did you see anything?
Plenty. Here, put these on.
Oh, Alice, you didn't.
Well, even nuns have wash day blues.
Polish, polish, polish.
Where?
In the nails,
nails. Hell, let's go in here.
There.
Look, look, there's a stairway.
Sisters and brothers and cousins and aunts.
Sisters and brothers and cousins.
Shh. What is so quiet?
Walk
here.
Straight. I can't wait. Oh, it's just love your place, sister. I'll be back.
She's been sick.
Who's sick? You're pushing me. What? I don't care.
What's so funny?
Oh, I'm just thinking of that guy, Skeeter, we left chained up in that room back there with a case of wine. Boy, that guy is going to squeeze a few, you know it. Hey, how'd you ever think of that monastery? How'd you know about that? You used to date somebody from there or something?
Simple. I knew the janitor hung out at Kelly's bar, so I slipped him a few.
Hey, that's a great idea. Slipped him a few. Yeah. Slipped him a few what?
Would you just step on it? I want to get our dough and split.
All right.
I'll Silver away!
Oh, Skeeter, get down! Get down!
Hey, Tex, look at that.
Look at what?
Get a load of all them nuns up there in that bug, will you? Man, they are driving like a bat out of hell. Look at that. Boy, I'll catch up with them, want to? Did you ever drag a nun? Boy, that'd be fun.
Just drive.
I'm going to catch them. Hey, look at that nun in the back seat. Boy, she needs a shave. Hey, Tex. Tex, that ain't no nun. That looks like that guy we left tied up, isn't it? Huh?
Hey, you know, for once I think you're right. That is Skeeter. Step on it. We gotta stop him.
You got it.
Come on.
Monastery.
happens, we're going to be in a lot of trouble.
Trouble? Oh, I don't know. I don't know, Chase. I don't think I could hurt a nun. I don't think I could do that.
You hurt who I tell you to hurt, or I'm going to hurt you.
I could hurt a nun. I could do that.
Okay, let's go.
Pull over!
I ain't your sister, Fruit Face. Pull over yourself!
Fruit Face?
All right, all right. Enough of this Mr. Nice Guy stuff. They want to play rough? Then we'll play rough.
Hey, wait a minute now, Tex. You ain't gonna shoot no nun, are you? I mean, you shoot a nun, I'm going straight to hell, brother.
Pretend it's a penguin. Dutch, I told you, you didn't make it, Dutch. I told you, you didn't make it, Dutch.
Why don't you ever listen to me, Dutch? Listen to me. You didn't.
Come on in, everybody. Now that the rabble rousers have gone, perhaps this board can get down to business.
Right. You still haven't got the minutes to the meeting.
Oh, really? Is Bobby Taylor here?
I'm here.
Bring her in.
Oh.
Oh, Olive, you're going to have a lot of good luck.
Oh, no.
As you can see, we now have the secretary and the book. Olive, please. Do you wish to continue with this charade?
No, ma'am.
Then I suggest that we take a vote immediately.
Right.
Olive. Hold the phone for us, Mrs. Riley.
It's two nuns.
We got a couple of vote members to be heard from.
Yeah, and you're going to be one voter short. Go and get her, boys.
Congratulations, Madam President.
Well, thank you.
And now I have something else planned.
Well, what's that, Will?
Come on, let's go.
Go? Where are we going?
To get married.
Oh, oh God! I thought he'd never ask.
Well, her daughter came home one afternoon and didn't even stop to play.
here from the Harper Valley PTA. Well, the note said, Mrs. Johnson, you're wearing your dress is way too high. It's reported you've been drinking and are running around with men and going wild. And we don't believe you ought to be bringing up your little girl this way. And it was signed by the secretary, Harper Valley PTA. Well, it happened that the PTA was gonna meet that very afternoon. And they were sure surprised when Mrs. Johnson wore her mini skirt into the room. And as she walked up to the blackboard, I can still recall the words she had to say. She said, I'd like to address this meeting of the Harper Valley PTA. Well, there's Bobby Taylor sitting there, and seven times he's asked me for a date. Mrs. Taylor sure seems to use a lot of ice whenever he's away. And Mr. Baker, can you tell us why your secretary had to leave this town? And shouldn't Gwyneth Jones be told to keep her window shades awful completely down? Well, Mr. Harper couldn't be here 'cause he stayed too long at Kelly's bar again. You'll smell Shirley Thompson's breath, you'll find she's had a little nip of gin. And then you have the nerve to tell me you think that as a mother I'm not fit. Well, this is just a little Peyton place and you're all Harper Valley hypocrites. No, I wouldn't put you on because it really did, it happened just this way. The day my mama socked it to the Harper Valley PTA. The day my mama socked it to the Harper Valley PTA.